Hi, this is Binat Online English School, and here is Nizar. Hi, Nizar.
Hi, Nick.
How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
So I'm going to interview Nizar and ask him some questions about English. Nizar, where do you come from?
Originally, I was raised in London. My dad is Yemeni, my mom is Romanian, but yeah, I grew up in London.
Okay, so do you speak English as your mother tongue?
Yes, English is my mother tongue. I speak that every day. I also speak Arabic with my dad and Romanian with my mom.
Yes. Okay, that's cool. Here in Binat, we are teaching online. So could you tell us what do you think about online learning?
The thing with online learning, especially nowadays, is that it allows a lot of flexibility and for you to mix with other students from around the world. So you're not bound to a classroom and you're not fixed for time. So I think online learning is where the market is moving at the moment, and many people around the world now are taking advantage of this online flexible learning.
Do you have like online learning experience?
I do. So for example, I learn Russian with you. That's part of my online learning. I've done courses online for programming as well, and that's given me the flexibility to, you know, choose when I could sit down and learn as well.
What are the advantages of online learning for you?
The advantages for me is to be able to move at my own pace, that I don't have to go to a specific place to learn. I could do that in the comfort of my home. It's a very relaxed atmosphere. And again, the pace is as fast as slow as I want it to be. So that's really an advantage.
That's cool. Nizar, could you also share with us, for example, I mean, those of you watching probably learning English, it's interested to know how to master English, right? So you're trilingual. So could you share us some ideas of how to become native? Because even the name of our school is BNAT, which means be native. So we're trying to teach students to become like natives. So what's your suggestions and recommendations for those who try to learn English as, to become fluent?
I think the first thing is to understand why you're learning a language, what your goal is. Do you want to just know a few phrases as a tourist? Do you really want to understand the language so you could learn this at a deeper depth? Because if you do, then it's a life journey.
What if this is a tourist level?
Yes.
The tourist level is required. What do you recommend, for example?
I would recommend that you grasp the basics first. I think it's very important to grasp the basics and practice to vocalize the words often. I think this is very important when you're learning a language.
Okay, yes. All right. Do you think it's important to learn a language with a native speaker?
Yes, I think that's very important.
Why?
For several reasons. First, pronunciation is very important. Also, when you learn a language, you learn it usually very formal, but when you learn it with a native also, they could help to learn colloquially, and I think that's very important.
So you're learning the language the way it sounds in the streets, like the real English.
Yes.
Okay, so, and other recommendations for those people who want to become like fluent, for example, some people say that, I want to be like, you know, like a native.
Yes.
Do you think it's possible to be like a native?
100%. I think
how?
If that is your goal, for example, I think the first thing you have to have in mind is that this will be a life journey for you. So don't get too frustrated if maybe at times you'll find it a bit difficult. Sometimes you'll be finding things very easy depending on your personality. Some things will be easy, some things will be hard, but it's a journey. And I think that's very important to keep in mind, that the journey is the important
thing.
That's
awesome. What are some techniques that you can share? Mm-hmm. For example, you have been learning language, right, yourself, and you are into the languages.
Yes.
So what are those methods, I mean, just from you personally, that you could recommend to our listeners?
Well, methods that I've used, for example, is I force myself to think in a language. And that's very important for me, to become familiar and...
To vocalize it or just to think?
I first think in the language, and then vocalization is also very important. And this is why it's important to have a native speaker, because you don't want to learn wrong vocalization.
To interact with?
Yes, it's very, very important. And again, I'd always say to people, whether you're learning it as a tourist or whether you're learning it to be a native speaker, I think it's very important to master the basics before moving forward. I think these are very important.
Yeah, because when you master the basics, you feel like you know something and you can move
very
on.
Important.
Well, that's great. Well, Nizar, thank you very much for taking some time to join us.
Thank you, Nick.
Thank you for coming to Binat.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Bye-bye.